Hello everyone, and welcome to Let's Play Blood Bowl Sundays! And it is a very special Sunday, because it's Christmas. God, this could not have come sooner. My life has been complete and utter chaos thanks to this holiday. Who the heck are we playing this week? The Reikland Reavers. Oh boy, we're playing the human team on Christmas! That's a little profound, actually, but whatever. Alright, so let's see. What are we going to do? Oh, hey, I can actually get inducements. 90,000 gold. Alright, let's see. That's not enough for a wandering apothecary or a wizard, unfortunately. God, I would love to have a wizard at one point, but that's really only for teams that can't afford it. So, might as well buy one Bloodwiser babe, and that is really all I can buy, isn't it? Because I can't buy Ripper. He's too expensive. I can't buy Ghoul Chewer. I can't buy Morgenthorg. Can't buy Scrappa. And I can't buy Dribblesnotch. Okay, well, I guess that's all we're doing. So let's see. One Bloodwiser babe. You have bought one keg. Wait, why do I buy a babe to buy a kit, whatever. And then they bought extra team rerolls. Fantastic. Can't wait for this game to get started. Alright, so this is actually a pretty classic matchup, to be completely honest, because, you know, it's a human team versus an orc team. This is basically what the box set has been forever. And yeah, these teams are basically the exact opposites of one another while being as close to similar as Blood Bowl will allow you to be. The human team is faster and slightly less armored than the orcs, while focusing on more of a passing game with their overall roster, can be flexible enough to do any particular role. Meanwhile, the orcs, while they are flexible enough to do any particular role, they are considerably slower than the human team and are more specialized in the whole beating the living crap out of the other team with their mix of Black Orc Blotskers and Troll. The human team does have the standard setup of lineman, catcher, thrower, blitzer, big guy. Somebody get me out of the snow. I'm tired of being here. So, personally, I would say feel free to root for either team, because I'm kind of honestly rooting for the humans. That doesn't mean I'm not going to give it my damnedest, but to see the humans win on their particular holiday would be rather interesting. Alright, so what are we dealing with here? Looks like three catchers on the pitch? Oh no. Enraged fans hurls rocks at Tuskbreaker.
Oh,
No, Duskbreaker! Because of course. And that's immediately broken armor. Fantastic. With... And of course, their guy is just fine. He's just stunned. Oh, and of course, the big guy has block. Alright, so the basic human idea here is to bunch up all around the ball carrier and hope nobody dies. We'll see about that now, won't we? Alright, I'm gonna get one block on the ogre. Even if you do have block, you still only have 2 strength, which will allow me to basically do this and get right next to the ball carrier, which puts you in a bit of a predicament, especially since my guy has guard. Now, who does he have to do in the ball carrier? Jacob van Aldhoff. Weirdly, I'll probably be able to pronounce these names. Plus 1 agility, block, nerves of steel, pass, and safe throw. Why he's got all the frickin' catchers right next to the guy with the ball and not spread out across the field, considering that, you know, he's got a 4 agility, I have no idea. Alright, let's see if we can knock this guy over. Yes! We're not going to be able to break his armor, but at least we'll be able to do something. And the camera has gone completely crazy on me. I don't think you understand the idea of the cage. The cage is supposed to protect. Plus 1 strength and guard. He really should have been on the line. No, no dodging. Only moving. Thank you, Mystery, for not being a complete disappointment. Wait, dirty player. Oh, they have the team spread out a little bit. That's good to know. Well, in that case, we'll go ahead and hit this guy. Which will free up Gluck to help Grimmar. Move up there. Which will allow Tokus to do a 2-dice block. And push him a little bit further up. Well, Graber stays over here. I don't think he'd be dumb enough to move the ball up, but then again, the AI has surprised me before. Oh, that's gonna be a 3-dice block. No, a 2-dice block. And he's moving the ball up. But why? I don't see a good reason for this, other than the AI really thinks that it can score for some BS. Again, 2 agility, he dodges out, and of course, he makes it. Because the computer will never fail one of those rolls, ever. Go ahead and stand him up. I don't think the computer is in... Nope, not yet. Not unless he pushes it twice, which is kind of a dangerous move. So, what we're going to do is we are going to try and... You don't have any skills, because of course not. Alright. Gore thrust? Thrust some gore. Fantastic job there, my friend. And our first injury of the game, and he doesn't use his apothecary on it. That's a little odd. He's just gonna use Rassle. Which kind of screws me over. Reroll! No, don't follow up. But if we could take out the ogre... Yeah, of course, the mighty Zug was not going to fall. And I've got that ball pretty well protected. No. Great, the humans have gotten one injury, and I've gotten one injury. And another thrower has the ball. See, that's what should happen when you try and dodge away with an ogre. He should trip over his own stupid feet and fall flat on his face. Okay, or that can happen. No, I'm good. And of course, somebody is calling me on my phone. Is it important? Yeah, of course it is. Okay, I cannot take this right now, so I will call them back in just a second. And let's see here. What to do? No, don't follow up. Just let him fall over with broken ribs. That's fantastic. Alright, note to self, edit out the last some odd minutes because I've been on the phone. And we're back! Now, what the hell were we doing? Oh yeah, we were trying to beat the living tar out of the human team that's slightly more well-equipped than the rest of us. And, of course, we just can't get another injury for the life of us. Is there anything else we can do right now? Not particularly, no. So I'm going to break up the video here so that way I've got slightly less to edit.